fellows. Let's meet Ken. He loves programming, but he seems to be unhappy because as a beginner, he has trouble with programming. Unfortunately, he has no idea of programming. He don't know where to start and which language is good for him as a beginner. That's what he knows. So, what next? What should he do and where to find? So guys, I am Jay, this is Embedtronix and I am here back with complete tutorial series of C language. We will discuss here some very basic points and cover complete topics step by step. So stay tuned and now let's get to the introduction part. In 1967, the great man called Martin Richards developed BCPL, that means Basic Combined Programming Language. And another guy named Ken Thompson, working at Bell Labs, developed B language in 1970. He respected Martin Richards and chose B from the BCPL. Ken Thompson is the developer of Unix operating system and he used B language for Unix development. And finally, one and only man, Dennis Ritchie, modified the B language and developed C language in 1972 at Bell Labs, USA. Dennis Ritchie suggested Ken Thompson to reproduce Unix operating system using C language, so more features can be added, and the biggest feature was the portability of Unix system, and so Unix reproduced in C language. And the timeline of the C language follows as. And now let's move to the next section. Oops, Ken again. He has got some questions. So please let's discuss those questions. C language, something there? Oh. He doesn't know why use C language. He want to know why C is still so popular and is it easy to learn and remember? Do C programmers have good scope, good future or not? So these all questions are here and let's move forward. So we'll discuss here some features of C language so that all questions get covered. C have low level feature. That means assembly code can easily be written using C language. Second, C is portable. That simply means that it can run on any compiler with no or little modification. And the third one is that it's powerful. So in the context of powerfulness, it provides a wide range of data type and functions to use, and the biggest advantage is that it can access hardware directly. And C have the technique of modular programming, which simplifies the bigger module and provides specific small systematic structure to work. And the next, C introduces the concept of pointer, which is major advantage of C language. Pointer holds the address of a variable, and we will discuss some more about pointers in our next tutorials. Let's discuss applications of C language. So we come to know the working areas and awesomeness of this language. We have discussed here the features. So it's time for the applications. In the first, C language is used for making different computer applications. C is used for writing embedded codes. Embedded codes are used in embedded industry, which is a different branch of technology. Most of the robotic and automation industry work with embedded C, which is just identical brother of C language, and we use those languages in our daily life. Let's get to the fourth point. C is used for making compilers of different programming languages. In fact, the interpreter of today's famous language, Python, is written in C language. Next, C is used for writing codes of different systematic driver for specific hardware. And the core of different games, it may be 2D or 3D, are written in C language. and also the kernel of your operating system are written in C language. So now, Ken is happy and he knows the advantage of C language. He knows C is productive language and it's easy to learn and easy to remember. So now, that all questions about C language, what and why, we know that. So there is something we are living which is called compiler and interpreter. Yes, we got that. Always, as a beginner, we most of the time confused with compiler and interpreter. What are these things and why they mean to every programming language? So let's find out. Compiler versus interpreter. What is compiler? Is it a thing to eat? No? So let's find out. A compiler is a program which reads the source code and outputs assembly code. It's called a compiler. In next, we write our code in C language, which is a high level language, so compiler converts program into lower level language which is readable to machine. Now interpreter. Interpreter takes single instruction as input. The statements have the slower execution. And the third one is that the errors are displayed for every instruction. And the memory requirement is less as its execution is line by line. And now, in short, we can conclude that about the compiler and interpreter. We give complete program as input to the compiler and our program is in the human readable format. Whereas the interpreter takes single line of code as input at a time and execute that line and it terminates the code execution as soon as it finds the error. So now we are done for this tutorial and what we have discussed is the history of C language, features of C language, applications of C language and compiler versus interpreter. So what you have to do is to subscribe our channel for more informative tutorials like this and share as much as you can with your friends so we can reach to the maximum people and they get better understanding. For your any questions you can comment down and please leave a comment whatever you felt so your good or bad will help us to improve. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.